And all the people say, sometimes feel like I got no friends. Can't trust a soul like I'm Snowden. Right by the bed, keep it loaded. Lord of mercy if they're broken. I don't ever sleep, yeah, I'm wide awake. If you try to pull up to my place, beam is gonna hit you a mile away. I promise one of us gonna die today. Helicopters in the sky, now we can't escape the eyes.
Alright, so what you just watched was the deadlift session that I hit yesterday, where I moved 6 plates for a 3 rep total, which is a PR. I did 6 plates for a double last month, but I wouldn't even count that second rep as a double. Looked like I locked it out, but I actually didn't on camera, but count as a double anyways because it looks pretty good on film. This is the strongest I've ever been. I am weighing around 200 pounds. I feel incredible. A lot of pressing power, minus a few legging injuries from overuse from Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and the hard weightlifting sessions. I'm doing pretty good shape. In terms of injuries, tendonitis in both arms. That comes and goes a little bit more in my right arm. During my lifting sessions, normally it's fine. During Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, it can act up. My coach thinks my cartilage is used from all the explosive movements. He says that most people would give up when they're put in like various positions, but me with the brute force power and being able to muscle my way out of it, he thinks that I'm overextending myself via that route and it's causing the cartilage around my abs to be loose. Around my back it hurts too, like it's almost like my ribs wrapping around. Honestly, not really sure how that's going to get fixed besides rest, and I don't want to rest. So we're just kind of going with it, taking it a little bit easier when it comes to it. And then I have a little tweak in my shoulder that still allows me to, I can still press perfectly fine. It just hurts a little bit when I do like face pulls and high rows. Besides that, besides some pressing movements, haven't really had to like lay off much of the workout training a whole lot, and laying off a little bit of Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, like taking a little bit more rest in between each rolling session. Not each rolling session, like if I do like 3-4 minute rolls back to back, the fourth one might be me rocking back and forth in the bathroom because I hurt so bad, and then waiting for the inflammation to go down a little bit. Quite honestly, we're doing pretty good though. In terms of what I'm running, not on SERMs anymore. I am on raloxifene to see if it'll help my gyno. Technically, it's a SERM, which SERMs can technically boost your testosterone a little bit via the negative feedback loop that it causes with lowering estrogen, blocking your estrogen, which causes your testosterone to go up as like sort of a seesaw to balance it out. Treating it... The cat just meowed really loudly. Treating it sort of as a piece post-psychotherapy. I don't know if it'll do much. I don't really think I had any suppression to begin with, but we're seeing how that goes. Relatively speaking, I think I'll have 700 in a year's time, assuming I take it slow, strengthen my weak points, and build off of that. The training that me and my coach are employing, we're training the muscular system and the central nervous system. Muscular system, training the muscle to obviously strengthen it, get it thicker, build size, build mass, build strength via myofibular hypertrophy and sarcoplasmic hypertrophy. And then we're training the central nervous system to get stronger as well too, which is different from the muscular system in that it is much longer rest periods. And then we're training the body to strain without destroying it, the muscular system side of it. So I'll do like a 2x5 with a 5 minute rest on overhead press, back squat, lunges, Turkish get ups to improve my body's ability to put energy out. And this allows me to train on days that are following hard training sessions, so I don't need the 72 hours of rest before I hit the gym again, or the 48 to have optimal pressing power. And so like yesterday I did the heavy deadlifts, massive super long back workout, Zercher carries, Zercher shrugs, seal rows, rack pulls, the deadlifts, and this is going to allow me to train on the days after that and still improve. So it's kind of like they build off each other really well. So getting stronger muscular wise, and then training the central nervous system so my central nervous system can be maxed out and my muscular system can be maxed out. That's what's going to create the strongest picture for my training moving forward. And so I'd love to do a powerlifting competition the next year, and I'd also love to compete in a fighting sport. I kind of going towards MMA right now. I just want to do something that will either kill me or prove to me that nothing is going to stop me. And I'm limited to no single activity that I could ever be in front of. But yeah, no, training's going really well. I'm going to hopefully be recording more content still. I started a new job on Monday. I'm now working for Culver's. So 45 hours a week. It's in Madison. Decent little bit of a drive. So we're going to hopefully still be recording, still be doing everything. We'll still training 2 times a day and new fighting sports. And it might be a little exhausting. I'm going to move my training days to my off days. So I'll do like 2 Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu sessions or 2 a strength session, BJJ session on my off days, which will allow me to keep like have an off day on like a work day so I can come back and record YouTube videos, sort of like max out the various times. Because like for me, like most people keep like their weekends to off days on the gym. For me, that's optimal time to train. I'm able to get rest beforehand. I'm able to eat a good meal, obviously, really dedicate some energy to the gym. So I've never really taken a rest day on my like Saturday, Sunday, or whenever I was off for work. So that's sort of the plan. And shortly after this, I'm going to go visit my girlfriend in Whitewater. I'm going to go see her tonight. And then go to church with her tomorrow. And yeah, we're just kind of vibing. It's been a good day so far. Going to probably watch some more Cobra Kai and get maybe a little bit more work done. I just cooked up some chicken breasts, so I have lunch and dinner ready. I had 15 boneless wings for breakfast, and then I had a protein shake after my workout. So we are all proteined up, going to recover well. I'm going to continue hydrating throughout my day. I hope everyone has a great day, and I'll talk to you guys later. Peace.